My name is Arish Abushamji. I'm an 18-year-old freshman from Great Neck, New York. When I learned that I was accepted to Northeastern University, I was ecstatic. However, when I learned that I was accepted into the NUN program, I was hesitant to say yes. Even though I love traveling, I have never been away from home for more than 3 weeks. I was afraid to leave my friends, family, and my hometown for 3 months. After finally deciding to attend Northeastern through the NUN program, I became increasingly excited as I learned more about Greece and the places that I would be able to travel to. As my time here is winding down, I know I made a great choice to study in Thessaloniki, Greece. Adjusting to the new culture was difficult at first. The language barrier made it difficult to communicate with the locals, and the general strikes made transportation very difficult. I wanted to learn as much as I could about my surroundings and about the people living in Thessaloniki to help ease my assimilation into Greek life. My service learning opportunity contributed greatly to my knowledge of Thessaloniki. I started my service learning experience with the United Societies of the Balkans, or USP, a nonprofit organization that deals with various issues in the Balkan Peninsula, as well as providing a local library composed solely of donated books. Every week I went to the USP office to help with research about these issues. This year, USP's research was focused on lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender rights in the Balkans. I learned about the gay communities in Greece, the Balkans, and the rest of Europe. In Greece, gay rights are becoming more and more popular. The annual Gay Pride Parade in Athens has been running for 5 years, and even though it's still not common to see gay couples throughout the streets of Greece, there are several gay-friendly clubs and bars. Through my travels around Europe, I got to experience firsthand cultures different from that of Greece. I was fortunate enough to travel to Istanbul, Turkey, and Amsterdam in the Netherlands. In Turkey, gays are still discriminated against, and every year there are dozens of hate crimes committed against them. I was not really all that surprised to learn that the gay community in Turkey was not very big. In Amsterdam, however, the gay community thrives. Gays are welcome in society, and it is very common to see a gay pride flag waving from the tops of buildings, and even gay couples walking throughout the streets. After all, Holland was the first country to legalize homosexuality and same-sex marriages. I found it very interesting that I could travel mere hundreds of miles and experience cultures so different from one another. Seeing these different types of cultures made me realize that living in a society that is more open to different types of people is a lot easier than living in a society that limits your freedom as an individual. Visiting these two countries enhanced my service learning experience in addition to my overall experience here in Greece, and I came to further appreciate the free community that I live in the United States. Overall, my service learning helped me learn a lot about my surroundings here in Greece, as well as prepare me for what's next. I'm glad that I will be able to take the relationships I've made here, as well as what I've learned from service learning, back with me to Boston. Living abroad in Greece has prepared me for almost anything life wants to throw at me.